Yes. I only joined because of a bird sanctuary on the Farne Islands. I mean, that's how you get drawn into this stuff, isn't it? You think, all right, nesting is interesting, but I want to see these bad boys hatch, you know? And you think, well, come back. And, so, and then you're in, and once you're in the National Trust, that's it. There's no, you can't leave. It's just that you're an apostate if you leave. So, and you're just trapped in this world of overpriced travel rugs and chutney and fudge, lots and lots of fudge. It's Liberal Democrat, I suppose, if anything at all. And then I thought, perhaps the reason I had been forbidden to vote was because at the general election, I had publicly supported Caroline Lucas, the Brighton MP, who's Green. Because I'm not sectarian in politics, and I would like there to be an electoral pact between Labour and the Greens, which seems only sensible. And I think Caroline's better. And what I do love about the Green Party is Caroline is now co-leader, but she used to be leader. And at that time, when Caroline was leader, the Greens, they had a leader who was on the TV all the time. She's, you know, she's elected MP, so she's successful. She's media savvy. She's good on camera. She's quick. She's articulate. She's popular and charismatic. And the Greens thought, no, this gives us way too much of an unfair advantage. We must replace Caroline with an unknown Australian amnesia. I said that at a charity gig, and Natalie was in the audience. And afterwards, someone brought her around. I don't mean she'd fainted. I mean, she's quite thick-skinned by now, you'd think. But someone brought her backstage and said, you're going to have to apologise for what you said. I said, look, I can't apologise, because it was A, a joke, and B, true. And it wasn't spiteful. So she came up, it was a bit awkward, and I just gave her a big hug. I said, look, come on, we're all on the same side. And I think it'd be all right, because, I mean she'd have forgotten about it by now, I'm sure. But I also voted Green in the last election because my MP is Chuck Amana, let me rock you, Chuck Amana. It's quite right-wing and has a rock-solid Labour majority. So I thought, well, I will vote Green because he's going to win anyway. And then I felt guilty because I thought, what if he loses by one vote and it's my fault? Because I do hate floating voters, those people who just don't know and make up their mind at the last minute. Well, last time I voted Lib Dem, but this time I'm thinking of giving Golden Dawn a try. Just have some fucking opinions and stick them until I tell you they're wrong, will you? But I thought I'll vote Green because of the things that the Greens were saying, which is what I wanted Labour to be saying. Like, get rid of Trident. You've got to get rid of it. It's so expensive. They're now talking about it costing about 200 billion Trident. I mean, it's madness. It's not going to be used. And if we did use it, it would mean that we got obliterated or we were about to be obliterated. So what is the point? But some trade union leaders support Trident. They say, you can't get rid of Trident. There's a lot of jobs tied up in Trident. They say, you can't justify weapons of mass destruction as a career opportunity. That's like saying, well, you mustn't crack down on paedophiles. Think of all the employment tied up in confectionery. In fact, it's exactly the same as that. That is a precise analogy. So if you do in any way believe in our nuclear deterrent, I'm afraid that proves you're a paedophile. People say, well, what would you do with the 15,000 people who lose their jobs? I'd say with 200 billion, they'd get quite a nice redundancy, and they'd say, I'm going to the Bahamas, you can stick to Terence up your arse, frankly. But the railways, you see, Labour said, well, we might renationalise the railways if we kind of get round to it as the franchises come out. And the Greens said, no, we just take it. We're going to have the railways. And that's not even a radical point of view. Most people believe in renationalising the railways. Most people of all political backgrounds believe we should renationalise the railways. But I have to say, you're clapping enthusiastically because most of you are my sort of age range, and we do tend to be somewhat nostalgic and romantic about, because in order to be really passionate about renationalising the railways, you do have to have forgotten quite how grim British Rail actually was. I mean, you know, we tend to think of it as this golden age of steam with Bernard Cribbins on the signals, and standing on the track is Jenny Agutter, and she's naked with an Aborigine. I mean, it was safer, more reliable, more affordable than private railways, but as a retail experience, it was miserable. And one thing that privatisation has done is it's recognised that we're a nation of consumers now, and we drink coffee. We used to be tea drinkers, but we didn't walk around with cups of tea in plastic, in cardboard cups like people do. We didn't, you know, I mean, we didn't have cups and saucers as we walked around shopping centres. But now, and coffee is immediately better with privatisation. It doesn't matter for me, because I've got coffee at home. That's not why I get trains, but for some people, maybe it's important. But I was at Peterborough the day that the East Coast Line was taken over by Virgin, and it was like a coup had taken place. People in uniforms were handing out leaflets saying, remain calm, there has been a change of ownership. And anyone that protested was taken away to a football stadium and tortured. But My point is that British people have become consumers in a way that we weren't in the 70s, and train stations are turning into shopping centres. When you get into London, it's ridiculous. King's Cross is a mall. I mean, St Pancras International is a retail park. They have everything in there. I found a train in there the other day. Honestly, I couldn't believe it. I'll tell you where it is. It was just behind Jojo Mamon Bebe. If you don't know what that is, it's a high-end baby clothes shop. I don't know if it's really French or just boredom and family money, but I think it's good to have baby clothes sold in train stations because you never know when a travel companion might suddenly deliver and you've got nothing in 0 to 3 months on you. If you don't have basic French, Jojo Maman Bébé means Jojo Mother Baby, and I expect it was probably founded by a woman called Joanne. But everyone calls me Jojo. Now, you call yourself Jojo. You've just decided that. That's not the recognised diminutive. I can't abide people who choose their nickname and then tell you what it is. Well, of course, my real name is Penelope. But when I was younger, my little brother couldn't pronounce Penelope. And so he used to call me Ploppy, and it kind of stuck. And so everybody calls me Ploppy. I think you're 38 and you're representing me in court. Fucking grow up.